The cloth mask that I wear is meant to protect you, and the cloth mask that you wear is meant to protect me.
But now that the Delta variant is on the scene, can cloth masks protect us from getting sick? Doctors say this is the most contagious COVID variant yet.
People who are infected with the Delta variant shed a lot more virus than other versions of this virus. So any mask is going to be less protective than it was against, for example, the Alpha variant.
If you're using a cloth mask, it's important to check it and make sure it still fits well and is in good shape. The CDC recommends checking a mask for loose ear loops and signs of wear. They recommend holding it up to the light to make sure the light doesn't come through it. And as with any mask, it needs to fit properly.
A mask should fit snugly against your face. It should cover up to the bridge of your nose and cover your mouth and chin. It should be snug. It shouldn't have major holes at the bottom for where air can escape or on the sides. It should be something that fits your face and you can actually tell that it's actually protecting you from breathing on other people.
With such a wide variety of cloth masks and some homemade, Dr. Adalgia says medical or surgical masks might provide better protection because they are made to a certain standard. In fact, some hospitals like Sinai in Northwest Baltimore don't allow cloth masks. You have to wear a medical grade mask inside.
We're in a healthcare environment. It's a high risk environment. And we want to provide the best level of protection for everyone, both we want to keep you healthy and we want to stay healthy. And so the surgical masks are best able to do that.
Experts agree that any mask you wear is better than no mask when it comes to slowing the spread of COVID.
Mask wearing continues to be a cornerstone of preventing the spread of the pandemic. And again, if everyone's wearing their masks, that's the way that we're going to really make progress.
Doctors say if you wear a well-fitting mask, there is no need to double mask, especially if you're vaccinated. Reporting live downtown, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.